FCPX Split Screen is an amazing mega pack for adding a stylish split screen to your footage, and we'll show you how fun and easy it is to use. In this video, we're featuring the category Grunge Layouts. These presets all have the same controls. We'll demonstrate using this preset. Horizontal 2, Drop Zones 1. The focus is definitely on style for this preset, so we'll dive into the style controls. Professionally designed border styles can be chosen from this drop-down menu, creating a cool visual. The color well can be used to select a different color for this style. Opacity determines the transparency of the graphic. And we can choose a blend mode that looks best for the style we're going for. For example, multiply can be a great choice for layering colors. In the Lens Dirt graphic drop-down menu, there are many choices for visual effects. Here's an example of a different look. Wow, what a difference! And with line style, there are a couple unique controls we can mess with. Length adjusts how long the center line is. And width determines the thickness of the line. Next, let's take a look at these on-screen controls. We can check this box on to see the line guides. It's a useful visual guide while editing. The line 1 Y position control lets us adjust the vertical position. And with Z rotation, we can rotate the angle of the line. Under drop zone controls, you can insert any media of your choice. If you're not sure how to do this, check out the link below for more on how to use our drop zone controls. Now, let's take a look at drop zone overall center. Drop Zone Overall Center will automatically position both drop zones in the overall center of the preset. Isn't that neat? Next, let's check out the background controls. We can use this checkbox to turn the background gradient on or off. And right under that, the gradient control lets us customize the gradient. In case you're not sure how to use gradients, be sure to check out the link to our gradient tutorial in the description below. Just a slight adjustment makes a big difference. And of course, we can use this menu to choose the best blend mode for the gradient layer. Now that's eye-catching. Hopefully this helped you to take full advantage of this plugin.